We got to teach our sons. Dude, yo, funniest thing about this tournament, like, three or more people have come up to me like, yeah, like, one of my opponents, he's like, yeah, I tried to watch, like, VODs to study for playing you, like, did you do, like, some rap thing? And, like, some other kid comes up and, like, keeps giving me, like, the smash cipher lines. I'm like, man, times have changed.
Yeah, yeah.
That's how you know we're in a world of new blood. Uh-huh. Pro controllers not disconnected. And
Piranha Planet Smash Bros.
Piranha Planet,
very brave new world.
And we've got two players that I'm unfamiliar with. I love seeing this, man. The new blood coming out. We've got Zion versus Korn.
Yeah.
So it's going to be Palutena, very meta character. You should be used to seeing her by now if you've been tuning in for the last 3 months of this game.
Yep,
if
absolutely.
If not, I'll tell you right now, she's real good.
Yeah, she's easily one of the most solid picks in the game right now. Just has that general consistency you really want. It's very good for her to follow her Nair and her Fair pretty easy, and she got some run speed buffs as well as the explosive flame that helps her get things started from pretty much anywhere on the stage as long as she's minding her space.
Yep, and on the other side, we've got Piranha Plant, newly released DLC. Too new, about a month and a half old now, but character that not many people have dared to bust out in tournaments. So we're seeing Korn paving the way.
Yeah. I feel like for the most part, people seem to think Plant is pretty bad. I think he's got some nice niche counterpick potential, but a matchup like this seems pretty rough for him just because he gets run over for not having the speed that these top tiers have right now.
Yep, also very hard to zone against Palutena, not only because of her speed, but she's got a reflector too.
Yeah, absolutely. But he is just running out there. Zion just kind of respecting his space, trying to ledge trap perhaps, but not really getting too hasty about it.
Yep, got a fairly even start just until about the last 10 seconds. Zion really starting to pull ahead here. Maintaining now almost a 60% lead. We're going to see him just go right in there, not respect the charge on the Poison Breath. Ooh, and the top of the up smash right there, that Pillar of Light, going to reach so far and pick up the first kill.
Yeah, some possible conditioning even coming on the end of Zion, just kind of letting him get there for free. All of a sudden, here I am with the kill move, you know, when I need it.
Yeah, almost daring his opponent to do anything other than air dodge on the way down.
Yeah, absolutely. That upbeat mix-up is going to be pretty interesting because I feel like he could put some air dodges in there, even start off with an air dodge perhaps, but he just seems to not really want to do much more than that, and Zion's going to be capitalizing on that.
Yep, got a few sloppy up B's just missing the edge from Korn, and that's going to cost him easy landing punishes. Now we've got Zion on the verge of closing this one out. Of course, three whole stocks to play with, and now we'll see how he's able to control the edge. Yeah, we see Korn just keep taking the high road with this up B. Definitely want to go to the edge. It's a lot safer, even if Zion's only picking up a grab or an aerial every time.
Yeah, absolutely. And the landing lag is pretty minuscule, but Palutena just has the speed necessary to catch up to you every time. Like, you're not really getting away from her, tricking her with slight movements and drift there.
Exactly, and her low and mid-percent combo game definitely makes you feel the pain every time you get opened up like that. Well, we're going to see Korn yet again just skip right past the edge.
Yeah, Zion looking for the spike, but doesn't quite find it.
Looks like he might still be learning the ropes of this character. Of course, being that there's been less time to play with Piranha Plant than everybody else.
Yeah. Definitely doesn't want to rush it too much. Walks right away from it. That was legendary. He walked right out of the range of that up smash. Nice shimmy.
Oh, and right into the down B, fully charged. So we're going to see Korn finally peel that stock off. And it looks like he's really content to just try to poke with the maximum range of that down B. Got to be careful, though, because you are a hurt box when you pop out of there.
Yeah. That's one thing we can see Zion even potentially taking advantage of. I'm not sure if he gets pulled to you if you do Palutena Nair, but I feel he'd be doing Nair out of shield. Yeah.
Yeah.
Just catching him.
Yeah, you could either punish it out of shield, maybe. I'm not sure if he retracts too quickly, or just try to challenge it head on, because once he leaves the pot, there's no more armor.
Yeah.
All right. Oh, banking on the regular getup, maybe a jump from the edge there. And Zion's just going to try to get underneath the down B yet again.
He's not quite sure what to do about the move right now, but he's been making adjustments to the rest of his playstyle, so it really doesn't matter as much as it should be. Going to apply some poor DI there. That's unfortunate.
Yeah, I feel like Zion really wanted to win the game by calling the down B and hitting.
Yeah.
Either with up smash or with something else. But you could tell he wanted to send a message toward the end of that match.
Yeah. Stop hitting it, man.
Yeah. Also, Korn, got to love that Cuphead shirt he's wearing. One of the greatest games ever released. If you haven't played Cuphead, definitely check it out. And put him in Smash, by the way, if you're watching Nintendo. Please just do me that quick solid. Yeah.
Be a crazy zoner.
Best game, man.
Dude, if you could swap, I could talk about the potential of this kit for a while.
Just saying, Cuphead is greater than Kingdom Hearts 3 by such a significant margin. Cost one-third the price.
Ooh.
Anyway, here we go.
Conversation for another time.
Yeah. kicking off this game, too. And we see again Korn going all the way up and over with that up B.
Yeah, I feel like Zion just needs to focus himself on catching the landing. He knows what Korn is going to do. Perhaps it's, you know, a bit of the no mix-up, as people seem to call it, where he's really just expecting this kid to change his playstyle, and he hasn't done it quite yet. But it seems he's reluctant to catch these landings, for sure. Just kind of respect it. Because I believe he could be grabbing him when he does the down B. I don't think it removes your grab box or sets up anything different with your hurt box.
Yeah, it's just that he pulls back so quickly, right? So I think you have to be ready for it.
Yeah, Apollo's grab is huge. So you just
snatch him up. I don't know if it's shield grabbable, to be real with you. Yeah. Okay. That's something that the plant meta will have to develop a little bit more before I have a definitive answer on. But, oh, man, all I know is that Korn is making all of his money with that down B right now. And we see a counter come through from Palutena. Just get around that forward smash.
Counters are so active in this game. Pretty crazy.
Yeah, they really are. Palutena's feels especially long.
Yeah.
All right, what's he got from the edge?
Down tilts at the ledge. He could be looking for those a little bit more just because Plant does have that Captain Falcon syndrome where he pokes a little bit above the ledge on his way up.
Oh, yeah, a lot.
So he could be, could be fishing for those pretty hard.
And Zion keeps trying to go for these drop zone dares, but since Korn is recovering high every time, it's not working out. So I think, you know, neither of them changing their strategy up too much, but that's what makes them keep missing each other in that situation.
Yeah.
Oh, and an SD. All right, there goes Zion's first stock. Gonna get the fair. Oh, could have led right into a dash grab, but instead Zion, hungry for another fair, just gonna miss the conversion window.
Yeah, it seems he's been trying to convert into rising fair off of these low percent hits. He did it off of Nair earlier as well. You just have to know your bread and butters with characters like this.
Yo, that was actually so clean.
Yeah.
Did the Patui, the spiked ball, neutral B, all the way in the depths of the bottom blast zone, still able to recover. Plant's recovery, you know, in terms of distance, not too bad.
It's actually pretty good. The mix-up that you have with the character is quite nice, and especially because Nair is pretty decent and pretty low lag if you actually manage to stay in the air.
Yep.
So you just use Nair, you use the down B, you can charge to mix up where you're looking, get the backer. He's got a lot of potential for a mix-up on his way back, but once you understand how to challenge him, once he actually gets to the ledge, and how to ledge trap him, he really can't do too much, especially as Palutena.
Yeah, definitely not a character with a lot of options to get out of that spot. And you see all the super armor coming through. Korn just not challengeable while he's inside of that pot. Zion's going to have to either wait it out, because of course he's only got a finite amount of time that he can hold it for.
Yeah.
Or just back off, know where he's going to reach at the max distance, and try to put an up smash or up air there.
Yeah, exactly. Even just down smash him. I think down smash would be a fantastic pick just because it comes out, I believe, faster than F smash does. And the people getting hyped for Korn.
Yo, let's go Korn. Looks like a young kid too.
Yeah.
Love seeing the new blood come through, do some big things.
Yeah, absolutely hype. I'll always say it, man. It takes a lot of guts to come out here. So that's the first big step. You should already be proud of yourself for coming out here and attempting to grind. You should always be grinding. Don't ever listen to someone that tells you, you know, oh, you shouldn't go to tournaments because you're too bad. Don't listen to yourself. If you tell yourself,
you might land something like that. Let's go, Korn.
Exactly. There's always potential for something more.
Yo, that was unreasonably sick. Obviously, you know, shouldn't have run into that, but it was just super funny to see it.
Yeah.
I'm loving that the crowd is backing Korn to the fullest right now.
Yeah, gotta get hype for your boys. And he's gonna get it going.
Oh,
keeping that defense up, keeps running back.
I mean, the down B, every time he hits that, that's nearly 20 damage. Even if it's not fully charged, it looks like it just did 18. Oh, the get-up attack, the bravery of this man.
Yeah, great get-up attack. Plant having one of the best in the game.
Oh, that's what I wanted to see. Okay. All right, finally, man. I got what I wanted out of that set. For the first round one pools match, that was as good as it gets. We got a young dude out here with the whole crowd behind him. I don't know if you guys can hear them in the background, but they're going bananas.
They're getting hyped for the boy. Yeah, I can hear it through the headphone.
So that was definitely fun to watch. And it could not have ended in a better fashion, right? Like, Korn has been going for that downbeat the whole set.
Yeah.
And you're just waiting for that one moment where the up smash is actually going to connect from Zion.
Yep.
He does it, walks away with the set 2-0. So, man, that's some good stuff, man. Normally, you know, the first few matches of the tournament can kind of be a little slow.
Yeah, laggy. But that one was definitely, it seemed like they were both at least adjusting to the pace, you know?
Yeah.
They're both, they...